measuring things up, and cleaning up our vertices. What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. In this video, we're going to clean up our vertices because right this minute, you would have no idea if there was two vertices over and on top of each other. Secondly, I want to show you a way of how you can measure the distances that you've already placed down, as currently, the only way is for you to manually count the little boxes that you currently have. From there, we will then go on to creating a hole in our surface, but I think we should really tackle this problem right this minute before we go any further in our 2D design in Blender Precision Modeling. Starting off right where we left off, we have this here. I really do hope you went and did the challenge, and this is your floor plan of your house. Now, I want to show you how a vertex can go completely undetected. So I'm going to go back into our top view, which by now you should know is number 7, or by hitting the Z. And I'm going to select this face. So with number 3 pressed in face select inside of edit mode, I'm going to hit X to delete this face. I won't be saying these instructions much sooner, but just to make sure you're aware of them. And then if I hit number 1, I will go into vertex select. So information on the screen is displayed down on the bottom right hand side. And one thing that isn't adding up is that there's 10 vertices. However, there should only be 8. I have 2 squares in here. So if I select all of this, we can see that I've only selected 8 of the 10. Now, this means that there are some vertices that are directly on top of one another. To explain this a little bit better, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just create a cube. You don't have to do this. I want to just create a cube to show you exactly what's going on. So here's our cube. If I go to our cube, remember when I tried to select all the vertices last time, and I showed you that on the other side, I couldn't select this one. This is exactly what's happening with our current vertices that are on top of each other. To be able to select a vertex, a line, or a face that is on top of one another, you have to turn on Xray up on the top right hand side. When you turn this on, you will be able to see through objects and select through objects. So now you can see I can select right the way through. In fact, I could even select just the one on the other side. So now with that tackled there, we know that there are extra vertices. So if I go back into our top view here and move ourselves over here, now if I turn on Xray and I select everything, we can see that I'm selecting all the vertices. Now I personally know where these extra vertices are. So just to show you, if I select one here, I just turned off Xray, hit G to move it, you can see it's hidden right there. Another way you can do this is by turning on Xray once again. You can select a whole bunch of X-rays, a whole bunch of vertices, and you see here I have 2 vertices selected when I think I only have 1. It should be like this, just 1 of 10. So if I select these 2 and I hit right click, then I can do merge vertex at center. But let's say you have your floor plan and you have now hundreds of vertices in front of you. You are not about to go and select each vertex one by one to find this out. Don't worry, there is something else to do. So I'm going to undo that last little change that I have here. So right here I have 2 vertices. Make sure you're on Xray. Select everything. You can do this by clicking A. And then from here I'm going to right click, merge vertices by distance. You see here on the bottom right, it said it just removed 2 vertices. And what it's just removed is by this merge by distance here on the bottom left. Merge by distance, it's merging any vertices that are closer than 0.0001 of a millimeter. So in other words, right on top of each other. So if I hit that, you can see once again, I'll just update that it removed 2 vertices. And we can go and check that by selecting the vertex that had 2 vertices in one point and moving it, and you can see that it is no longer there. So that there is how you can do vertex cleanup both manually and automated. Next, let's go about figuring out your distances. Now, Blender has tried here to give you something to show you distances, and that is in the overlay options. Over here on the top right, there's overlays. If you click this, on the drop down here, you will see there is something called edge length. If you click this, nothing will appear. This is because nothing is selected as of yet. If you select everything, you will see very faint text here that you can't really see. Now, if you want to be able to see this, you're going to go here into Edit, Preferences, Theme, 3D View, and there is right the way down here. Edge Length Text. Let's turn this into a nice bright white color. Unfortunately, Blender doesn't have the option of making this font any bigger or any more accurate. And this is a big one, especially for us when we're doing solid modeling and precision modeling, because we know that this line here is 10.15. However, we have gone to 10.1. And you will also see there is a slight drawback that if I make this line, just going to go and move this, I'm hitting Y to move it, and I'm moving it 0.02, it has rounded up our measurement. So I wouldn't rely heavily for accurate dimensions on the overlay of length of edges. Now, if you really want, you can go into Edge Select and you can just click on edges to be able to see how long they are estimated to be. There is an angle here, but I find that the angle just doesn't work. Even when you do this to a solid face, it gives you some really weird results. Anyway, so from here, inside of edit mode, on the left-hand side, there is the measure tool. Before we go into the measure tool, I want to remind you about snapping. So, we talked about snapping in the last video, where we had increment snapping on the absolute grid. This was our grid snapping. You can switch this snapping to be vertex, so we can snap things to the vertices of our lines. So let's click on vertex, so then we have the option to be able to snap things to vertices. So I'm going to go back into our vertex mode to be able to see all our vertices, and then I'm going to hit on measure. Now just out of here where there's nothing to measure, if you click, nothing will happen. If you click and drag, it will create a line. If you click on that line and pull out, it creates an angle but removes the distance. If you click and drag, and while it's selected, you can hit X to delete, and you can click on a line to select it to click X to delete. So we know that this line here is 10.15 millimeters. One thing that is pretty nice about Blender is that if you're just close to a vertex, it will snap to a vertex. I think you can see that. I'll do my best to show you. You can see here, it will snap directly to a vertex that's close by to it. I'm just going to delete all these lines. So let's say you have created a line out and you want to move this point to this vertex. Well, we click it to be able to drag it around, hold down Control, and now we will be able to snap it both to the line, center points, and to vertices. So there you have it, 10.15. Unfortunately, this is a drawback of Blender. We cannot have this parametrically change. So if we go now into edit, and let's say we want to be able to edit these, you've just seen that our measure tool has disappeared. If we go back into measurement, our measurement appears again. So that there is one of the slight drawbacks. And on top of that, if we move this now on the X, let's say 1 millimeter, and we go back to our measurement tool, this did not move 1 millimeter. And you will manually have to move this using our snapping back to the vertex to be able to see our dimensions. These dimensions are great in the sense that they're very accurate, but they're a little bit cumbersome. Lastly, let's go over how to get an angle from this. So if you're wanting an angle, I'm going to delete this measurement line. You can have more than one measurement line just by clicking and dragging off to another corner. I'm going to delete these now. You click on one. You click to the opposite side where you're trying to get your angle from. Let's say we're wanting this angle here. We click on our line and drag it out. And you can see now we have this angle measurement coming. And once again, we hold down Control to snap. And that there is how you can get an angle measurement from your drawings. Now that you have more control over your vertices and precision drawing, I want you to go over the current plan that you have in your Blender setup. I want you to do some measurements, some angle measurements, try out the overlay, see how unprecise Blender can be when it gives you those measurements, and also see how precise you can be using the vertex snapping to get the exact measurement that you're looking to use. I want you to truly make sure that your drawing is clean with no overlapping vertices, to then go on to the next video where I'll be showing you how to do fillets and holes. Last but definitely not least, a big thank you to my patrons. You guys are awesome, and I would love to have you come and support me on Patreon if you're enjoying these tutorials and the content that I'm making. Thanks for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.